will continue the transformation from the first normal form in second and third normal form. So this was a diagram, the dependency diagram obtained for the table in the first normal form. Now, to convert in second normal form, what we like to do is to get rid of partial dependencies. And these are the dependencies based on the primary key. So it's this dependency and these ones here. So in this way, we'll no longer have redundant information. As you see here, a lot of redundant information is from these dependencies. So I have project number 15, and even if I repeat, I have 15 all over, and I know that project number 15 is evergreen. I also repeat here a lot of times the project name. So to do so, what we need to have is to reduce the redundancies. And I remind you that anomalies can be caused by redundancies, for instance, having the same project number, but the name we can say Evergreen and in another place Evergreen Project. And in this way, the same project will be represented differently, and this will be like an insertion anomaly. Now, to get rid of these partial dependencies, the process is very simple. First step is to take the primary key that is composite in this case and to create three new tables. So we'll have one table in which we'll keep the combined primary key, project number and employee number, and we'll have two other tables that will have each attribute from the primary key as a different entry, as a different table. And we take each attribute because we have partial dependencies both related to the first attribute and to the second attribute. So because we have this partial dependency, we'll write here project number, and because of these partial dependencies, we like here employee number. Now, next step will be to assign the attributes. And to do so, we'll just need to think which are the attributes that belong to one or to another of the tables. So if we take project name, we see that this one is dependent on both primary key, but also is dependent only on project number. So being dependent on project number means that it's good enough if I am writing it in the project number table, in the first table. It will be a table for the projects. And then in this table will appear only once. Now, looking at these other attributes, I see employee name, job class, and charge hour are dependent on employee number. So we'll write all of these in the employee table. And the remaining attributes that are depending only on both elements of the primary key will be added in the third table. So in this way, we'll obtain the following three tables. We'll have a project table when we have project number and project name. And now we have only one dependency. I no longer have a partial dependency because here the primary key has only one element. So there is no partial part of it. And we have the employee table, which will have all these attributes, and also will keep the transitive dependency that we had in the initial diagram. Now, the last table, which can be named project table or assignment to the project, between an employee is assigned to the project, and which will keep the number of hours worked in that assignment by the employee. So you see that here we already did another modification. We change the name of the attribute hours in assign hours to reflect the naming convention. So this is a second normal form database, because all the tables do not have partial dependencies. However, they might have transitive dependencies. So a table is in the second normal form if it's in the first normal form and has no partial dependencies. In other words, if I have a composite primary key, no attribute is depending on only a portion of the primary key. Now, as an interesting note, is that if the primary key has only one element, like here, then I cannot have partial dependencies. So a table that is in the first normal form and has a primary key with only one element always will be also in the second normal form. Now, next we'll discuss about converting to the third normal form. The algorithm to convert to the second normal form had two steps. First of all, we identify the new tables by writing each key component on a separate line and creating also a new table with an initial primary key. And then we assign the dependent attributes based on the minimal dependency. So if we have a dependent attribute for one of the initial parts of the primary key, we'll assign this first, and then the remaining attribute we'll put in the table that contain the composite primary key. Now, to convert to the third normal form, what we'll try to do here, we'll try to no longer have transitive dependencies. So the remaining transitive dependency we'll try to solve. And if you recall, this table has no transitive dependencies, this has no transitive dependencies. So the only problem for the third normal form is this table, which is here. So a table will be in the third normal form if it is in the second normal form and has no transitive dependencies. So this determination must be between two attributes that are not part of the primary key. Still, transitive dependencies will cause data redundancy and may cause data anomalies. First step is to identify the new determinant. And for a transitive dependency, the new determinant is the element that will determine other elements. In our case, will be like the job class. Then we'll, so this is a new determinant. Then we'll need to assign some attributes that are determined by this new determinant. And in our case, it's a charge hour attribute. So you see, so we assign the charge hour attribute, and we may name this new table table job, that will have two attributes, a job class and a charge per hour. Now, once we have this new table, make no sense to keep the initial table in that state. So the next step will be to remove the attributes that were assigned to the new table from the initial table that was in the second normal form. And doing this, we'll obtain two tables now. We'll have the initial project employee table, in which we'll keep just the foreign key that will reference the new table, which will be this primary key job class. And then we'll have a new table job that will have as primary key the determinant and as the other attributes that were determined by the transitive relationship. Now, as you see, all these tables are all in the third normal form, because we don't have neither partial dependencies or transitive dependencies.